Oh, so well. Famous for skyscrapers, Jersey Shore, hot dogs, the subway, and so much more. The other, known for Martin Luther King, peaches, its own lesser skyline, and Ray Charles. But the effect that the state of Georgia could have on the New York metro area is profound.
I'm not one for hyperbole, but you cannot overstate how important these two runoff races are for the Democratic agenda moving forward.
The political science department chair at John Jay College is among many analysts talking about how two open seats in the U.S. Senate from Georgia can affect us.
Create way forward for a bigger stimulus package to help the economy recover from the COVID pandemic.
An NYU political science professor makes a point that New York Governor Andrew Cuomo has made over and over, including when he was last in Georgia. It's called the Peach State, and thanks to a Jim Crow era law, it requires anyone winning statewide office to have at least 50% of the vote. Nobody did on election day, so the top two candidates in each of the two Senate races being contested go head-to-head on a special election day, January 5th. Current Senator David Perdue, a Republican, faces John Ossoff, the Democrat, and there's another race for the other Georgia U.S. Senate seat. Republican Kelly Loeffler was appointed to it this year after it was vacated. Democrat Raphael Warnock, the senior pastor of Martin Luther King's former church, Ebenezer Baptist in Atlanta, is running. Warnock has big ties to New York. He holds not one, but three graduate degrees from Union Theological Seminary uptown and is the former assistant pastor at one of the city's most prominent churches, Abyssinian Baptist in Harlem. But the New York angle on this whole story is much stronger.
The Georgia races could also determine whether or not New York Senator Charles Schumer, whose office is here, heads up the Senate as Senate Majority Leader.
The Senate has 100 members. Right now, there are 48 Republicans, with the GOP on course to pick up a seat each in Alaska and North Carolina, even though those races haven't been called. That would be 50 with Mitch McConnell leading them. If the Democrats win the two Georgia seats, the number would become 50-50.
And if Democrats win both those seats, the Democrats have a lot of leeway to accomplish a pretty ambitious agenda.
A 50-50 split would mean any tie vote would be broken by the president of the Senate. That is Vice President-elect Kamala Harris.
Not something we see often, but it will certainly make Vice President-elect Harris a very important voice in the Senate.
James Ford, PIX 11 News.